started here. And if I hear y'all snoring out there during the set, I know that that gumbo was real good. Could still come down a little bit more. Northern water is sweet. It flows like wine through the mighty Mississippi, and the heart that pounds in me still lingers in the shadows of New York City. And I miss the songs on my stereo, how they free my heart to roam. Oh, and L.A. Airport, won't you fly me home? So I traded the whiskey for wine. He said the bottle was draining the warmth from my lines. Now I wish I had the time to be the fool drinking whiskey in the morning sunrise. And I miss the songs on my stereo, how they free my heart to roam. Oh, and L.A. Airport, won't you fly me home. Search for the song to sing. I need one for the streets and one for the harbor. If I lose the melody, I'd be the chill of the wind in a cold blue northern. I miss the songs on my stereo, how they free my heart to roam. Oh, and L.A. Airport, won't you fly me? I miss the songs on my stereo, how they free my heart to roam. Oh, and L.A. Airport, won't you fly me home? To the same sweet song. We all wanna go home. To be home. Thank you. It's truly a pleasure, and you know, it's only once in a very blue moon that we get to do this and have the treat of having all these musicians here on one night and one weekend, and it's really a great pleasure to have a wonderful songwriter and I guess one of my very favorites, Mr. Frank Christian, here from New York, and I'm gonna bring him out now to play some guitar with me, and also Denise Frankie, if she's around, and a wonderful vocalist that she is. I'll give him a warm welcome here. I guess you don't have much choice, do you? One of the things that I always wanted to do is be able to write the score for a Tennessee Williams screenplay. And unfortunately, that doesn't look like it's ever going to happen. So this next song is a tune that I I wrote for a film of his called This Property Condemned, which is, I guess, one of my favorite films that he wrote the screenplay for. It starred Natalie Wood and Robert Redford and Robert Blake long before they went on to do Doddville and L.A. type films. And this song goes out to Tennessee, wherever he is this evening. Out in the wide, deep blue, I suppose. This is a song from the new album called Year Down in New Orleans. I truly need a year down in New Orleans. The hum of a southern drawl that I can understand. And should you meet my sweetheart in New Orleans, kindly pass my heart into the safety of his hand. I remember clover in the fields south of New Orleans. Now when I'm lonely, I send my heart down to New Orleans to chase my memories alone down to my dreams. How I miss the clarity I left there in my youth. Will there be another heart who can endure my solitude? Roses grow so lovely in New Orleans, and their petals do recall the mystery in his eyes. So should you go to the garden in New Orleans, kindly tend a rose beside his heart for
super glue in seats so that when y'all sit down tonight, you couldn't get back up and be warm in here all night long. Back when I still lived in Houston, Rosalie Sorrells would come through and visit me every now and then. And she had this great big book that she kept all of her mementos in. That thing weighs about 50 pounds. And she'd come to my house and we'd get to drinking beer. And then we'd want to go downstairs to her van and get that great big book out and carry it all the way upstairs to my apartment and go through it page by page. But it would take 4 or 5 days to do that, and we usually spent that amount of time drinking beer and going through that book. And one time when Rosalie came through, we were going through that book and stopping and picking songs and trading songs, and I had just written this next song, and Rosalie looked at me and she said, "By God, you finally wrote a song that I like." Of course, it was very late at night, and it was one of those nights when it didn't sink in for a few minutes what she'd actually said. So later on in the evening, she asked me to play the song again. And so I played it for her, and Rosalie said, "Well, you know, you must have been reading my diary when you wrote that." And I got her back because I said, "Rosalie, I wouldn't touch your diary because there's no telling where that diary's been, who it's been with." So. This next song goes out to Rosalie Sorrell. It's a tune called Working in Corners. Well, west of New Orleans, and I'm a fighting off a cold from these winter rounds. Houston, you're just around the corner. Hey, I think I'll stop off here in Lafayette, Lord, and have me another round. 'Cause I've been working in corners all alone at night, pulling down whiskey, keeping my eyes away from the lights. I'll never be a fool, but I will gamble foolishly. I never let go of love till I lost it in my. I don't wanna go to sleep, 'cause I just might dream. And I'm stronger now. There was a man in my hometown. He sang so pretty, I'm glad he turned my head around. But I've forgotten now to play a one. Lord, I didn't have a word to say, just holding a stranger's hand. 'Cause I've been working in corners all alone at night, pulling down whiskey, keeping my eyes away from the lights. I'll never be a fool, but I will gamble foolishly. I never let go of love till I lost it in my dreams. I don't want. I just might dream. City streets at 5 a.m. I would have stopped to phone you, but I'm almost home. At my back door, there's a porch light that's shining. Hey, I just don't mind living here by myself if I leave it on. 'Cause I've been working in corners all alone at night, pulling down whiskey, keeping my eyes away from the lights. I'll never be a fool, but I will gamble foolishly. I never let go of love till I lost it in. I don't wanna go to sleep, 'cause I just might dream. I don't wanna go to sleep, 'cause I sure can dream. You know I sure can dream.
I don't wanna go to sleep,
I sure can dream. You know I sure can dream.
Thank you. This next song is a tune about two folks whose era rested in the 50s. They've always remained very vivid in my memories of childhood. And when I was a young girl, of about 8 years old, I guess, one hot August Sunday afternoon, my grandmother and my mother and my brother and my sister and I all piled into our little Renault Dauphine and headed downtown Congress Avenue in Austin, Texas to see the picture show. And we were en route to see my grandmother's favorite star, Gregory Peck, in a movie called To Kill a Mockingbird. And it was a wonderful, wonderful, blistering hot August day, and in this particular Renault Dauphine, the heater was stuck on. And I, being the youngest child, had to sit in the middle in the back seat. And the heater vents were in the middle in the back seat. I had on little red patent leather shoes. And that Renault Dauphine is probably sitting in a junkyard somewhere with little red patent leather shoes still glued to the heater vents, that car. But as we passed that day heading downtown to see that movie, my brother and my sister got into an argument and began to slug at one another. And I was in the middle. I got it. And every once in a while, my mother would reach back and go, "Knock it off!" And I was in the middle. And I got it. And then an announcement came on the radio in between the speech that my grandmother was giving about how much better her life would have been if she had met Gregory Peck before she met my grandfather. And they announced it on the night before Marilyn Monroe had died. And the car got quiet. And my sister was a big fan of Marilyn Monroe's and had, in fact, bleached her hair so many times that it was like cotton candy. She got very quiet, quit hitting my brother, put her head up against the window, mourned the death of her idol. My brother fell asleep with his face against the glass and butch wax dripping down into his mouth. And I was just glad for the peace and the quiet in the car. I've always associated Marilyn Monroe with peaceful things, hot August afternoons, red patent leather shoes, Joe DiMaggio, and a movie she was never in called To Kill a Mockingbird.
The sun will stop shining, and hearts will stop pounding. The screen is so lonely tonight. The men are out praying, and the women are singing. She died for the loss of a prime and lived on DiMaggio time. So farewell, you old Thames old city, with your waltz in the morning and your neon at night. I bathed in your loneliness, drank up your wine. Honey, I lived on DiMaggio time. And hearts fell paradise to rest in her eyes. She was no fading light. Oh, hot night dog is so long to the goddess. America's fatherless child. Immortals forever, and that queen of the camera was a master of wink and a smile. And even a shadow behind. So farewell, you old Thames old city. You waltz in the morning and in the neon at night. I bathed in your loneliness, drank up your wine. Honey, I lived on DiMaggio time.
Thank you. Well, I'm going to do one more tune here and then get on with the show. And we've got a wonderful show lined up for you. I'm going to be back in a little while. I'm doing an Austin City Limits on Monday night. Brian Wood is here and Dan Huckabee, who will be playing that, and Frankie, of course, and Lyle Lovett, who will be doing some work for me on that show on Monday night. This next song is a tune that is kind of special to Frank and I. We went and played this festival in Mexico, and the first night we were there, I had these songs translated, a bunch of songs translated into Spanish. and it was wonderful. I was so proud. But I didn't have them, you know, memorized yet. So I walked up and got the promoter of the festival to read the translations, and it was really nice. He read the translations before I did the songs, and people understood what the songs were about that night. And then he walked off stage and lost them. So I had to spend this 5 days at this festival with only one song in Spanish, and it became the hit of East La Mujeres. This is a Bill Stein song. Y'all are glad you came tonight instead of tomorrow night. We just want to tell you right off the bat that just coincidentally we all sat back there and changed strings before we came out on stage tonight. Getting close, Frank? Well, at least they've eaten, so they're not that. They won't be too impatient. This is a tune of Bill Stein's called Dream or Sueño. And if you catch on to the chorus and you want to sing along, please do, because it's a wonderful tune to sing along on. By my dying fire tonight, I see your face within the light. It smiles and fades like fleeting shadows on the ground. And with the river flowing near, brings back a song I used to hear when we were young and danced the streets of Spain. Rio Grande, agua contando, en la noche oigo tu canción, mi guitarra canta contigo una canción de mi corazón. Again, it's just a dream, I know, but then better a dream than never holding you to me. By the near the river's flow, I feel your warmth, and I remember oh so well the way our loving used to be. Rio Grande, agua contando, en la noche oigo tu canción, mi guitarra canta contigo una canción de mi corazón. Ocotillo's flaming flower, it ran as red as my heart's blood. How you left me for the ways of San Antonio.
beside the river flow, my fire dies, my memories grow once again, my dream is gone, I'm alone. Rio Grande, mi guitarra canta contigo una canción de mi corazón, Río Grande. Tara, canta contigo una canción de mi corazón, una canción de mi corazón.
We thank you very much. The show goes on. We'll have, I think, Mickey Merkins and Denise Frankie right up here. So y'all stick around.